Well, New York Governor Andrew Cuomo stunning the crowd after saying this about our country.
We're not going to make America great again. It was never that great.
But the Republican candidate who wants to take his job disagrees and now calls on the governor to apologize. Joining me now is that GOP nominee for New York Governor, Mark Molinaro. Thank you so much for being here.
Glad to be
here. So you're done. You're definitely the Republican candidate.
I am.
And you'll either be running against him or Cynthia Nixon.
Or both of them.
Or both of them. Yeah, how could that be possible?
She can remain on the ballot as a Working Families Party candidate. So it's a strange thing that happens in New York. She can stay on the ballot through November.
All right. Well, we'll have to see. So obviously he is saying he doesn't think America's great, hasn't ever been really that great. What was your reaction to that?
Gosh, I was raised by a single mom, grew up on food stamps. Tell me that America isn't great. I was the youngest mayor in America for a short period of time. And here I am, the most unlikely maybe candidate for governor of the state of New York. America has always been great. I was so ashamed and shocked that a man who has lived in privilege, I think he was born on third base and thinks he hit a triple, could think that America was never great. Even with our imperfections, this nation, its promise, its purpose, its principles, and its people have always been great. And that sort of determined march towards making things better, that's what has always made America great. I'm ashamed to think my governor doesn't know that.
And now you want him to apologize?
Yeah, he owes New Yorkers and the American people an apology. But then again, I don't know if he believes it, if he's lying, if he's just trying to win a primary. But at the end of the day, it's an insulting thing to say to Gold Star moms, to men and women who are fighting overseas, to folks who died in service, who, by the way, are on that blue line protecting our communities every day, to say that America was never great or wasn't all that great.
And not just defending Americans, defending people who are oppressed in other countries.
Absolutely. We've been the beacon of hope and opportunity for millions of people for generations. America, with its imperfections, has always been great.
Well, this was a statement from Cuomo. The governor believes America is great and that her full greatness will be fully realized when every man, woman, and child has full equality. America has not yet reached its maximum potential. So do you think by releasing that statement it was a mistake, or do you really feel like he feels that way and then realizes it could cost him votes?
Listen, this is a man who once proclaimed he is the government. I don't know that I necessarily believe anything they have to say. So I don't know if he's walked it back, if he's apologized. I really don't understand what he thinks, other than I take him at his word. He said America wasn't all that great. He's wrong.
And you told us a little bit about your story, that you grew up single mom, food stamps. Tell us more about that. Tell us about you.
Listen, my mom was. She was single for a couple of years. We grew up on food stamps. I thought I was the luckiest kid in my elementary school. We got a free lunch. But she taught us to work hard. I mean, she encouraged us to respect others and respect ourselves. Always had my grandparents in our lives. And she just, all of my family encouraged us to make a difference. And I was given the opportunity as an 18-year-old to run for village board in my hometown. Served a year, and then 1 year later served as, was elected America's youngest mayor. It was the greatest honor of my life. And to think that I was able to participate in this grand democracy, right, as this dignified duty of public service. America's great. America is great.
Thank you so much. Mark Molinaro, thank you.
Thank you.